How can you calculate the circumference of a code node cart wheel and use it to determine distance traveled? One of the great things about the code node cart is that it can be used to reinforce various topics. It can be used with physical science in mind, coding applications, as well as mathematical applications. This activity not only has a focus on coding with functions, but also reinforces the formula for circumference of a circle and how to use it to solve problems. The only materials needed are the cart, code node, and access to SparkView software. This lab is broken up into 5 activities: determining wheel circumference, using circumference to determine distance, investigating the magnetic field sensor, programming, creating a rotation counter, and then a final challenge of coding diameter and distance traveled. Keep in mind, if students have not had experience in calculating circumference, they may need some additional support with the first 2 sections of the lab. Once students have calculated the circumference of the cart's wheel, they will spend some time reverse engineering how the cart determines position using the bar magnet on the axle of the cart, along with a magnetic field sensor within the code node. All right, so I'm going to jump to the 3rd activity where students are going to be doing some reverse engineering and understanding how this cart actually determines its position. They will look at the magnetic field sensor on the back axle, and then they're asked to set up a track of a half a meter. This is an important part. The students need to make sure that they know to start this wheel in the same position every time. So let me show you how that works. I'm going to go ahead into SparkView and hit sensor data. And for this activity, we're just going to use the magnetic field strength. So I'm going to disable the other sensors and bring up a line graph that's going to show me magnetic field strength over time. On the bottom left-hand corner of SparkView, you see your live data bar. And right now it's telling me negative 1.8, positive 2.0. For this activity, it's really important to get as close to 0 as possible and maybe even mark your wheel with an arrow so the students know where to start. You'll see why this is important in a second. All right, so let me get it as close to 0 as I can. Almost there. And I'm going to click start. Okay, so you can see on the data bar, it's pretty interesting. They can use this data to gauge how many rotations the wheel has made. So they do some investigating with this. They do it multiple times and they recreate the graph. Then they're charged with coming up with a program. This is activity 4, where they have to come up with a rotation alarm. They can use any coding that they want, but the end game is to make sure that they have something that gives you a beep every time this wheel makes a full rotation. I've gone ahead and I have an example of the program. You'll also find this in the teacher version of the document. I'm going to open that up. Okay, take a look at our program here. All right, so this example states that as soon as it goes to a positive Gauss, that's the unit of measure for the magnetic field strength, it's going to give me an indicator beep. If it's below, it will not make any noise at all. So let's see how this works. I'm going to bring back up my graph because I want to be able to see this data bar again. Okay, as close to 0 as I can. Click start. So it's pretty interesting, as they run through this, they're going to see when they hit those peaks, it's going to give them an alarm saying I've done a rotation. And actually, when you're looking at the data, this is a half rotation when I'm looking at this first piece here, and then that dictates another half rotation. All right, so that's one coding program example. And again, you'll have that in the teacher version. The next challenge, the students are actually given the code. And this is where they're going to have to plug in the circumference that they calculated for the wheel of the cart. So let's open that one. I'm going to go ahead and show you the program. It's a bit more advanced because they're using functions. So they're actually creating a mathematical application in here saying that it's going to take the position of the cart. And again, they're going to go half a meter to start, and they're going to plug in that circumference. And they're gonna actually be able to have a counter that not only shows you the magnetic field strength for those peaks and valleys, but now you're gonna actually see a number that'll correlate with how many full rotations you have on the cart. Okay, I'm gonna go back here because for this one, I wanna add a new page because I want you to be able to see the magnetic field strength. And you see I've run this program many, many times. User entered for rotation. Let me clean that up for you. I'm gonna manage these runs and just delete everything. Okay. Check the program. Everything looks good. Let's give it a whirl. Again, I need to start as close to zero as I can. Pretty good, and start. Okay, so it's telling me that I've done about 4.5 full rotations, or should I say 4 full rotations and a half rotation. And they can actually look at this data bar and see how the magnetic field strength and this correlate. So that is the last challenge program in that activity. This activity may need to be broken up over a couple days, but once students have completed all the activities, they will have the knowledge they need to complete the questions in the question analysis section of the lab. You can access the student and teacher versions of this activity in our Teacher Resource Center at PASCO.com. Keep in mind, you can always challenge students to extend their coding programs, such as not only showing how many rotations the wheel completed in a numerical output on the SparkView screen, but also showing the number on the 5x5 LED array itself. Thanks so much for watching, and don't be afraid to let your students come up with other activities that use the code node cart. The possibilities are endless. You will find they can teach us a thing or two.